Okay, Michael, you got answers for me?
I think so.
Okay, good. All right, so let's look at the first one. Mutually orthogonal. Does that apply to PCA, ICA, both, or neither?
So it was one of the defining properties in PCA. So I would say PCA.
Okay, that's fair enough. That is actually correct. What about ICA?
I don't know. It's not one of the defining features. It wasn't even thinking about orthogonality.
That's right. And in fact, ICA, by finding independent projections, are almost all but guaranteed to find ones that are not mutually orthogonal. It doesn't care at all. So in fact, this is what makes PCA a global algorithm in the sense that it has this global constraint of mutual orthogonality, where ICA, really, there's nothing in its definition that cares about that. So this should be unchecked.
Okay.
I'm going to put an X there to represent unchecked. Okay, got it?
Yeah.
Okay. What about mutually independent?
So that was how ICA was trying to construct its, I don't want to say features. Yeah, I guess the transformed features.
That's right.
It was trying to create them to be mutually independent. So I would check ICA in that case. And PCA didn't use that language at all, so I would just not do that.
Okay, that's fair. I will point out, though, that it turns out that PCA is trying to do something that sometimes will create things that are mutually independent. But we'll see that when we answer the next question. But you're right, PCA does not care about mutual independence. Okay, what about the third phrase, maximal variance?
All right, again, I feel like this was one of the defining features of PCA. So it was trying to choose dimensions that maximized variance.
That's right. And what about ICA?
In terms of variance, again, it wasn't really discussed in that context.
Right. ICA is specifically interested in notions of independence, statistical independence, not in issues of variance. So, in fact, ICA does not care about maximizing variance. Now that we've gotten this far, let me point something out. It turns out that because of this orthogonality constraint, this lack of an independence constraint, but this goal of maximizing variance, there are cases under which PCA happens to find independent projections. What's really going on here with these three constraints, or lack of at least one in this case, is that PCA is tending to find things that are uncorrelated. By maximizing variance along orthogonal dimensions, it's finding uncorrelated dimensions. And that makes some sense given what it's trying to do, but that is not the same thing as finding things that are statistically independent. Again, there is a particular case, there is a specific case where that does work out, and that's when all of your data is in fact Gaussian.
Oh, interesting.
And why Gaussian? Because it turns out that the distribution that maximizes variance is in fact the normal distribution. That's my interpretation of a normal distribution. So maximizing variance means that what PCA is doing is it's trying to find a bunch of orthogonal Gaussians, more or less. Does that make sense?
Yeah, but you were saying that, and it aligns with ICA in that case?
In that case, yes, because it's going to turn out that uncorrelated ends up being independent under very specific distributions. But that's a coincidence. It's not a normal fact.
Ha ha.
But by the way, this is probably worth pointing out here something that at least I think is kind of interesting here, which is since ICA is only trying to find things that are independent of one another, here's our little symbol for independence, as opposed to things that are uncorrelated, things that are Gaussians, it turns out that whatever it is PCA is doing, it is not working under the same underlying model as ICA. Right? Let's think about what ICA is trying to do. ICA is trying to find a bunch of these projections, all of which are statistically independent. Right?
Mm-hmm.
What happens if I take a whole bunch of statistically independent variables and I add them together? In other words, I create a linear combination of them. What am I going to get?
Bunch of sums of things that are independent.
Right. And what does that tend towards in the limit?
I want to say the law of large numbers tells us that it turns normal.
That's exactly right. If I take a bunch of independent variables and I sum them together, that is, I create a linear combination, I, in fact, end up with a Gaussian. And that is the central limit theorem. So one argument you might make is that if you believe in a world where there are independent causes giving rise to observables, which is what ICA believes, then whatever you do, you should not be maximizing variance because you're guaranteeing to be summing together otherwise independent variables.
Oh, I see. So by trying to find things that are maximal variance, it's trying to mix together through the central limit theorem all these things that are independent. So it's specifically not teasing apart the independent things. It's trying to smoosh together the independent things.
Right, under certain assumptions about the distributions of these individual variables. So another assumption that ICA is making is not just that these variables are independent, but that they're highly non-normally distributed. And if that's the case, then ending up with things that look like Gaussians has got to be exactly the wrong thing to do, if that assumption holds to be true. Okay, what about Maxwell mutual information?
My understanding of what you described for ICA said that this is what it's trying to do. It's trying to find a new feature space where the features are maximally, the mutual information between them is as large as possible. So I would check the ICA in that case and not the PCA.
Let me clarify something you said. How can it be trying to maximize mutual information while also trying to make things that are mutually independent? I think you would describe them both in the same language. So what is it trying to make mutually independent?
Different features, the new transformed features.
Right. So each of the new transformed features is independent with all the other new transformed features. So what is it trying to maximize mutual information between?
The information, the content of the original features and the new features.
Right. So this is about joint mutual information between all the original features together and all of the transformed features. There it's trying to maximize mutual information. But inside the new transformed features, it's trying to make them pairwise mutually independent.
All right. I think I said that wrong because I understood it wrong. So thank you for clarifying.
You're welcome. But now you understand it right.
Maybe.
Okay. Let's go with that because you've got the check mark right. What about PCA?
I just X that. I don't understand what that would mean.
Right. So if I were to put something here that it could get a check mark for, what I put down is maximal reconstruction.
Right.
Right. And notice that maximal reconstruction of your original data is not the same thing as maximizing mutual information. Though, of course, in the limit, they work out to be the same.
Interesting. Okay.
Right. But the one projection that maximizes variance is not necessarily the same as the first projection you find for maximizing mutual information. So these things really are doing two completely different things. Okay, last two. What about ordered features?
So in PCA, it was actually assigning, you know, taking the maximum variance dimension first, and then the next, mm-hmm. you know, after that's been subtracted out, whatever has the largest remaining variance, and so forth. So the features end up coming out in a very specific order, and it has the property that you can drop the last group of features if you want to still have as high reconstruction error as possible, given the number of features that you keep. So I would check PCA for that.
Okay, good. What about ICA?
You didn't say anything about the ordering or how you'd actually find features. It seemed like in the blind source separation example that you gave, it just came out with the three. So I'm going to say not ordered.
That's right. And in fact, if you think about the blind source separation example, how in the world would you order people anyway, I mean, other than in the obvious way, it just doesn't really mean anything. ICA doesn't have a notion of causes being more important than other causes, merely that they're independent. So it doesn't really worry about ordered features. It turns out in practice that you can actually try to order the features by using something called kurtosis, which is the fourth central moment of a distribution. But that's really just something that's useful in some specific cases, almost by coincidence. ICA itself does not particularly care about ordering, at least not classical ICA. Okay, what about the last one, bag of features?
So I would view what you just said about ICA as implying that what ICA produces is a bag of features. There's no particular ordering to them.
That's
just
right.
A collection of things that make up the whole. I guess, you know, PCA, after you've thrown away whichever features you don't want, the features that remain are just features. They could be treated as a bag, I guess. So I don't know if I would check that or not. For symmetry, I guess I would say not.
Okay, but I'm going to say yes, because an ordered set of features is still a bag of features. But we would accept either a check or an X. Both are sort of perfectly fine. So what did we really learn from this, Michael? I think what we learned is these things have fundamentally different assumptions and are really trying to do completely different things.
Okay.
The only thing they have in common is that they're still trying to capture the original data somehow.
All right, I understand that, but I also learned the opposite, which is that they are really closely related and are trying to do very similar things.
Yeah, but their underlying models are different. So maybe that's actually a good point, Michael. So maybe a better way of saying it is their sort of fundamental assumptions are different, even though they're trying to do the same thing, which is capture the original data in some new transformed space that is somehow better. But if you think about it that way, they have two different optimization functions, two different fitness functions, two different cost functions. So even though they're trying to do the same thing, reconstruction, keeping the data around, their basic assumptions about the way that data is constructed are very different.
Okay.
Okay.